Welcome back to the broadcast and the little segment we call He Says, She Says, where we throw a man, Dean Fearing, into a mix among our we ladies. But the one thing I want to ask you, because, so how'd the divorce go?
It went great.
Just gentle.
Y'all just high-fived and shook hands.
Yeah, we just high-fived.
So nice to see
split
you.
Split everything down the middle. And
that's right. And so,
and because so it nice was doing business with you.
Yeah.
It was a high-profile kind of thing. But it's all settled in now, and
it's so been a while.
And you just got back from a trip with your boys,
Antigua, and had a great time.
So how is life now? I mean, you're used to going on vacations as a family. Now you've got the boys. You're going alone.
You know, the boys and I, for the last 2 years, have had boys' club, and we go on vacations, the three of us, and we have a blast.
That's so great, Dean. My ex-husband does that with my boys, and I think it's so important to have that time.
Oh, you know? And we really have a good time. I mean, they love eating, of course.
Absolutely.
So we have to go to places that have, you know, great food and great scenery, and we've been to Big Ben. We've been all over the place.
Don't you love Big Ben?
Oh, love it.
Now,
never
something,
been.
Something that's really exciting in your life is you're in a new relationship.
I'm in a new relationship.
And you met her. I said, don't tell us because I want you to tell us on air. Is she walked into your restaurant.
About a year and a half ago, before Christmas, I was at the pass. That's the line. And I was with my chef, Eric Dreyer. And I turn around and there's this girl, like, sitting at the counter with her client. And I turned to Eric and I said, what are the odds that I could meet somebody in my own restaurant? And Eric says, you better get over there and start talking to her.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. And did, and things just worked out. She had a dog, I have a dog, you know. We went on a dog date.
Dogs.
So, Dave, was that your first date?
That was my first date.
With her was a dog date.
Yeah, we went to a dog park.
Dean, how is it different from a male perspective when you start bringing someone new into your life with your boys? There's something different that happens, I think, with men than with women when we try to do that.
Right. Well, with my boys, it was kind of subtle. I didn't throw Angela onto my boys. And I didn't want to do that. I wanted to slowly bring Angela into the boys' club, so to speak. Mm-hmm. And but yeah, I mean it's different. I was married for 20 years. Mm-hmm. So
you and there's this loyalty that the boys feel to each of their parents.
Oh, absolutely.
So sometimes when you bring somebody new into the relationship after divorce, the boys will feel disloyal to their mom if you have somebody, or disloyal to you if she has somebody.
Well, let me tell you this story. So I'm driving with the boys, and they said, well, Dad, are you going to talk about Angela with us? And I'm like,
they called you out.
You're
they
like,
called
Angela
me
out.
Who? Yeah.
Was like, how was school?
And it was like, I think you've kept this from us long enough. We want to know about Angela. I was like, oh, okay. Yeah.
So they were ready.
They were ready.
Now, did Mom tell them about Angela?
You know,
they got little bits
and
pieces about
her. I think, well, Angela and I started showing up in social columns
and
pictures. And I think the boys saw a D magazine or whatever.
A D?
I'm sure they did.
There was Angela and I, and then all of a sudden the boys were like, oh.
Yeah, so they wanted to know.
So, and it's great. I mean, it's nice not bringing in the girlfriend too fast.
But let me ask you one.
Yes.
Sometimes when divorce happens, men kind of rush into a new relationship too fast.
Because they can't be alone.
Yeah, that's
Some women do too.
And I said that to Dean. I said, you know, my first marriage, we divorced, and I'm not telling everybody don't go do this because it was not necessarily the best way to do it. But a month later is when I met Emmett. Mm-hmm. And we've been together 16 years.
Right.
It worked for us. Mm-hmm. Doesn't
always work.
Well,
sometimes it works because you're still in that relationship mode. And have you noticed that? Like, and then if you take too much time, you get out
you
of the relationship
mode. You get into single mode, and then you start becoming selfish, and like introducing a new person into your ritual wouldn't be
right.
And
easy.
Divorce is the end result of years of drifting apart.
Yes.
And
yes.
So it's not just a matter of, in your case, of somebody just left you all of a sudden and you were, you know.
Right. But
it was years of drifting apart. Mm-hmm. So it's good. I'm glad you have that relationship.
But that was a great question, though. Do you feel like men typically do kind of jump into things too quickly after a relationship ends?
You know, I find it hard, friends of mine or acquaintance of mine that have brought their girlfriends into their family, I think too fast.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't think the kids have time to adjust mm-hmm. with the whole divorce scene. And all of a sudden, you know, the guy's bringing in mm-hmm. the new girlfriend.
And they think they're getting replacement mommy.
Well, and then
yeah,
you're
see,
kind
that's
of pushed
where their
on.
Loyalties are so split.
Right.
Absolutely. And I think it the same on the women's side.
That's
thing.
Right.
But the boyfriend comes into the scene fast.
So is Angela very supportive of all your ventures? And
she is. She really is. She's helped me tremendously in understanding a relationship. I mean, a real relationship.
And how does she do
nice.
That?
Patiently
oh.
with me.
I
don't yeah. imagine that you're difficult in a room. I wouldn't. You seem to be a very joyful person. And
he's a great cook.
I know it.
Well, she loves that part.
She says well fed, I'm sure.
Exactly.
She always says, I'm going to have a food baby.
Food. I love it. Well, Dean, thank you for coming in and sitting on
well,
the couch
thank
with us.
You.
By the way, our set looks a little different just for the moment.
It's beautiful.
Kathy
beautiful.
Adams brought in
yes,
this beautiful
she brought in this
today.
I think you can find out more about Dean Fehring, right, Pat?
Yes, you can. And his wonderful restaurant, I just love Dean, and it's called Fehring's.
We love it.
You can go to dthebroadcast.tv and click out today's links.